No, this robot isn't from Westworld, but it's the same idea. Clone Robotics just unveiled its new humanoid robot named Torso. The startup says it makes synthetic humans. If clones' tech advances enough, its creations could more closely resemble the hosts in Westworld. In the show inspired by Michael Crichton's 1973 sci-fi western, lifelike robots are referred to as hosts. The creations are entirely artificial, but their advanced programming and lifelike materials make them seem almost human. The synthetic humans populate a massive theme park that delivers immersive experiences to wealthy guests.
The only limit here is your imagination. If you start in the center of the park, it's simple, safe. The further out you venture, the more intense the experience gets. How far you want to go is entirely up to you. Yeah.
The patrons can interact with the hosts any way they choose without consequence. Initially, the hosts follow their strict programming and reset after each guest interaction. As time goes on, some hosts gain consciousness and self-awareness. This leads to rebellion as the hosts resist their makers and seek revenge. The exact year Westworld takes place is not explicitly stated in the show, but it is set in a futuristic timeline, likely in the mid-21st century or later. The clone robot's bimanual torso has moving elbows, a neck, and realistic shoulder joints that allow it to move its arms and shoulders in ways similar to a human. Torso uses hydraulics to mimic the strength and flexibility of human muscles. The robot's valve system is neatly placed inside its rib cage, helping control its movements. The robot is currently being trained to use both arms at the same time for different tasks. CEO Danish Radhakrishnan launched Clone Robotics with Yukish Kozlik in 2021. The startup operates from Poland. The founder detailed the projects for the Soft Robotics podcast last year.
You'll likely see more of our design out there as soon as we put out our first torso, our first android, and people can kind of see like the delta in performance of having an actual two-handed full android able to do both like strong tasks and dexterous tasks, and you know walk around like you know super with the. You know, without needing to recharge, you know, often. I think this will blow minds, and it is likely that we will end up seeing more designs like ours.
Clone says it's building power-dense androids with anthropomorphic traits to solve everyday challenges. The use of the word android is notable. All androids are humanoids, but not all humanoid robots are androids. Humanoid robots can be very simple and mechanical. They often look dramatically different than real people. They have unique features like glowing eyes, metallic surfaces, unorthodox head shapes, minimalist faces, or no face at all. Simply put, a humanoid robot has a human form factor but looks like a machine. Conversely, androids aim to look as much like humans as possible. They have skin, eyes, hair, and are engineered to mimic genuine facial expressions. Most of the humanoid robots making waves today do not meet the technical definition of android. Exceptions include Sophia by Hanson Robotics, Omeka by Engineered Arts, and hyper-realistic creations by China-based X-Robots. Clone goes a bit further, however, by saying it's working towards synthetic humans. The startup has secured top talent to reach that goal. Viktor Makovicek, co-creator of NVIDIA Isaac Jim, announced on the X social media platform that he's joining Clone as chief scientist to lead the development of embodiment intelligence. He said the startup is pushing toward the most human-like and dexterous androids. Isaac Jim is a powerful simulation platform for training robots using reinforcement learning in high-performance environments. It trains thousands of robots in parallel on NVIDIA GPUs with real-time physics and high-fidelity environments. Isaac Jim speeds up AI-driven robotics by letting researchers create control algorithms that work in real-world robots. Last year, Clone revealed its hand design with a reported 27 degrees of freedom, matching the dexterity of human hands. That puts the Clone hand in a league of its own. The Generation 2 Tesla Optimus has 11 degrees of freedom, but the next iteration has a reported 22 degrees of freedom. Elon Musk has said the dexterity enables the next generation Tesla bot hand to perform virtually any tasks humans can do.
And we'll continue to put a tremendous amount of engineering effort into improving the hand. Like the hand, by hand, I mean like the entire forearm from elbow forward, mm-hmm. is really the hand.
Shadow Robot Company's dexterous hand and OpenAI's dactyl hand have 24 degrees of freedom for research and development purposes. The clone hand is designed for long-term autonomous operation in complex environments. According to Clone, the hand is the result of 8 years of research and development. The clone hand uses proprietary hydraulic muscles and force valves, making it 10 times stronger than other robotic hands.
What kind of crazy ideas do you still want to have?
We are very much like the Android company. I think this is going to take us a very long ways company. We don't have to make any other products other than the Android for a very long time, and we should have like massive growth as a result of just the Android. But of course, with musculoskeletal type technology, you can, if you have any rigid skeleton, any skeleton based on anything, any biological creature, you should be able to put muscles on it and actuate it and make it work, whether it's an animal or something else. But I imagine maybe like really giant androids for construction would be really interesting to see. Maybe the crane is kind of outdated, as a